Okay, set.
Hi, good morning, Ms. Iwan and Dr. Laura.
Good morning.
Today we are presenting about does emotional labor promote gender segregation? So I will pass to Nicole for you. So emotional labor in service. Okay, we know that service is an industry where the business provider will provide not just good but their services to their customers as well. So breaking down emotional labor, emotion is a complex set of interaction in human nature. Where emotion in different ways we can feel or express ourselves. Well, emotions can affect on individuals at work, which brings me to the emotional labors by Hochschild, 1983, she mentioned that the set of feelings that are managed by employees within the workplace to display emotion and physical attraction between them and the customer. So, in terms of giving the service, the employees need to transfer their emotion to provide the service, a better service to their consumers, so that the organization will get good feedback from the customers as well. Furthermore, emotional labor abides social norms, belief which a person's behavior are under the organization's control, which means organizations are in control of their feelings when they are working in the service sector, especially in the, as mentioned in Nico mentioned about the frontline workers. So emotional labor, Chu said that it abides social norms where they abide their own feeling to give to follow the requirements and the criteria of the organization to transfer the emotions to their customer to have a better service. For example, like flight attendants, where the hostel believe that for flight attendants they need to cater their clients' needs even though they are tired or whatnot. And the next is emotion at work, where it divides into two, which is masculine and feminine, where masculine is an attribute that refers to strength, aggressiveness, in which traditionally associated with men. Long before, they believe that men only can do a muscular work, heavy duty work and whatnot. For example, in a construction setting, you can see that most of the workers are men, not women. And for the feminine side, the opposite is our attribute of masculinity. It's an opposite attribute of masculinity, where they see a feminine side is a more of a caring and aggressive side of emotion, which incline more to women. So this explain that feminine is more a caring personality or traits, and empathetic emotion. So we three as a group agree that emotional labor is gendered, and there is a clear sexual division of emotional labor between organizations today. For example, Blackburn, 2012, he explains the degree of separation in the workplace, where you can see that it has horizontal and vertical. So, the horizontal explains the extent of men and women working in different stages in the workplace. They are all in the same service industry, but then, for example, as I mentioned earlier, where in a constructive site, most men are working there. And in a nurturing, in a healthcare center or whatnot, there are more women there where they treat the patients well and they give a warm smile and whatsoever. So that is the meaning of the feminine side that mentioned earlier. So the next one is called the vertical separation, where it's a place for indifferent level in the same occupation, where men and women have different level although they are in the same organization, especially in a top management setting, where most of the top management setting, they, men are more superior compared to women in terms of decision making and influence a positive image of the company, where men has mostly dominated in the top management office. Next, I will pass to Eugene about quality of emotional labor.
Next, I'll be presenting about cost of emotional labor. What is cost of emotional labor? It's all talking about that. How, what causes them to behave this way? First, we'll talk about is deep acting and surface acting. This one is all produced by Hostis. Stated by Hochschild 1979, that deep acting is actually how they use their innate feelings, their inner feelings to express to people how to face them. Whereas for surface acting is somehow they, you can call it as they imitate someone, or they put on another mask to act and to show, telling people, giving face, while hiding their own emotions. Next, I want is to be empowerment. Is by Lupton 2000. It's actually stated it's actually a power given to someone to do something. What to do is that, for someone as a manager, give someone a position, let's just say like a supervisor or a captain, to ask them to do something. So they have to produce some work shown to them. Lastly, you'll be a constant monitor. Is by Jin, if I'm not wrong, it's Myun Jin 2009. Managers are always on the watch of the staff performance. So why they always behave this way is because managers and above, they are unsure whether the staff will behave better or they won't be unperforming well. So therefore, they have to keep on monitoring while supervising, informing them how work is actually to be done. Alright, so next will be the effect on emotion and labor. How will it affect them after all the past, just not the past four solutions? First will be emotional exhaustion, toxic emotion and control. Emotion exhaustion is all actually is about it's all actually stress based on their past acting, and then because they can't put on they can't put on their own personal experience or their personal feeling which they had back then, and then they bring it out to people. And so if you're facing someone, you can't simply tell them, and you have to show your grudge over to them. Next will be toxic emotion. They are same like this, not toxic emotion, negative emotion express. It's all the past feelings which they have hidden all along and they can't show it out to other people. Control, causing them to be unable to control their feelings to a customer. It causes them to, because sometimes some people, they tend to keep a lot of feeling into them when it's so, their bubbles actually very, some of them, their bubbles are actually very small, and when they reach to a certain limit, once it explodes, they'll start showing different kind of signs, different kind of feelings, so it's actually not very good to show it for other people. Next, this one will be actually a video, is about crazy flight attendants charged in a flight outburst.
Flight attendant facing charges for attacking other crew members and two air marshals on a transatlantic flight. ABC's David Curley at Reagan National Airport with the story. Good morning, David.
Morning, George. Tables really turned on this one. We're not talking about an unruly passenger, but an unruly flight attendant facing charges of interfering with the flight crew, her flight crew, not to mention a couple of air marshals. American Airlines flight attendant Joanne Snow, according to court documents, described herself as crazy and a train wreck, shoving, punching, kicking colleagues and air marshals during both legs of an American Airlines flight from Charlotte to Frankfurt last week. American Airlines released this statement, quote, "We are aware of the incident and take this matter very seriously. We are cooperating fully with federal law enforcement in their investigation and are working directly with our employees." It wasn't just the one flight to Frankfurt. The disruptive behavior continued on the trip back to Charlotte with the same crew in place. After landing, while the flight crew looked for help for Snow, she began yelling and screaming and tried to get around passport control. One air marshal says he handcuffed her for her own safety, then escorted her to an interview room. This isn't the first time we've seen a flight attendant making headlines with outrageous behavior. Remember JetBlue's Steven Slater's infamous bleep you to a rude passenger before he slid down the emergency exit? And the American Airlines stewardess who lost it on the public address system. Now, in this case, in the court documents, the crew says they suggested this flight attendant be taken off the crew. American Airlines stands by its statement that it is investigating the incident. Amy and George.
Surprising she was on both legs.
I know, that's what I was wondering. Yeah. Both legs of the flight.
Yeah. Oh, well,
glad everyone's okay. Thank you, David.
So basically, this video talks about how flight attendants are being treasured in the ways that the management are trying to control their employees. And when Eugene said about toxic emotions and emotional exhaustion, where in this video they explain how the flight attendants are emotionally exhausted with all the customers nagging and whatnot. So this shows that there are many cases back in 2015, 2014, and 2000. I think the earlier one was 2006, where flight attendants just outburst themselves and keep punching someone, punching their customers, and just walk out of there. Mm-hmm. So this is the video is all about.
Okay.
So next is about our personal experience. So I will pass it to Eugene first.
So for the past for my personal experience, what I've been before, actually I previously I worked in few restaurants. So I'll just give one example, Chili's. When I started off, this actually is there's no certain people that say, oh, if you want have many women or many men, so it's all actually quite equal. So at a part of moment that especially when we have this job role is what you call a host stand, which we are in charge of customers entering and customers servicing, how to handle the restaurant before we got before the restaurant start busy and crowded, everything start crumbling. So usually my managers usually like women in front there standing over there to be in charge over there. But when they feel that after a certain period of time, a few days later, like girls are actually asking that, can I change role, because they say I'm really just standing in front of the host stand there and it's very boring, very exhausting, you have to face people. Some examples when it's full house, people start coming in and they're asking why no space, why aren't you giving me slot, what time, how long do I need to wait. So this one, they give them a kind of pressure which they cannot control it. After when everything settled, they start to open up their feelings and start scolding by the manager, why can't I do this and why I can't do that. So it's not actually saying that women are actually much more weaker, it's just that sometimes they can't control their feelings, which makes them a bit sad, you know, that they don't know how to handle the job properly during workout.
So from your experience, what can you conclude? Women are better in emotional labor or they are not as good?
Not to say it's not as good, it's just that sometimes, maybe what I witnessed was the time was just that maybe this girl that she can't really handle her job properly, so I also cannot really say that, because not everyone is all equal. Some women have better control of their feelings, some not. So therefore I cannot conclude that men are definitely better than no women have safer be better as well.
Okay, thank you.
So in my personal experience, I worked in a call center in 2011 again. If I'm not mistaken, where our job is, we represent Celcom, where any customer that have trouble with their billings or anything with Celcom, they will call us, the company that is a representative of Celcom. So it was like 2 months after my working days, and then there's this one day where a lot of customers are complaining and being angry at me because I'm not a Celcom worker, but then I'm their representative. But then they keep nagging until I outburst myself, and suddenly my manager stopped the call and then direct me to his office.
Mm-hmm.
So after a few hours discussing about my problem during that day, so they decided to put me in a probation where I have to retrain again and be retrained again. So what I experienced is that, like Eugene said about emotion, toxic emotion and emotional exhaustion, it's really true, it's true. Where in my department where women strive more as compared to men, mm-hmm. in that department where the women seems to have, I don't know, a gentle voice or something, and the customer will like, oh, okay, no problem, it's okay, something like that. So women poses a more feminine side where they try to calm down their customers and whatnot. But as for me, I'm not that kind of person, not an upbeat person or a friendly guy. But then that causes a problem for me when that situation happened in my workplace.
So from your experience, yeah. So from what I heard is you think the gender segregation in terms of emotional labor types of job, service type of job, that it is applied.
Yeah, it the job requires that like, you answer the call and settle their problems.
So,
but we the emotional part of it is not a requirement, but it's automatically mm-hmm. considered an addition requirement for mm-hmm. us to actually work in the service.
Mm.
Area.
Mm. So the male
that is my experience.
your experience male are not so good in terms of managing
the customers, handling the customers' problem.
Okay.
So
thank you.
Is conclusion.
Right, so our conclusion. So, does emotional labor in service work promote gender occupation segregation? The answer would be yes, based on the empirical research we have done. We found that women dominates more in the service work and possesses a major challenge among men. Therefore, we cannot conclude that there is a gender neutral in the emotional labor perspective based on Nixon 2009.
Cannot conclude that there is a gender neutral meaning?
There is a gender neutral, which you cannot say that men dominates highly in this different work or no, women dominates very highly. So at based on right now, it's quite evenly among everyone. Even let's say examples which I searched, taxi drivers is one of them. Last time it used to be everywhere you sit around in taxi, usually there'll be all men on the taxi car. Right now, there's this app called Uber Grab Car, which also is actually so called what you call it, a taxi car. We also tend to see there are actually, in fact, a lot of women are driving a taxi car. Like, so that's why I concluded that there will be a gender neutral.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.